morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Fort Jackson, South Carolina, at the graduation of Companies A and B of the Second Battalion, 13th Infantry Regiment. The purpose of today's ceremony is to recognize the commitment of those young men and women in uniform standing in formation before you who have chosen to serve their country as soldiers. This review is the last official formation of the training cycle. Not everyone successfully completes this difficult period of training, but those in formation today represent discipline, motivated, physically fit soldiers. This is an important day, and these soldiers can take great pride in their accomplishments. To the parents and families of these soldiers, Fort Jackson extends a very warm and sincere welcome. You are just about to proud of them, and are equally proud that they have chosen to join our ranks. Since the gymnasium is considered to be outdoors, military personnel will remain covered and render appropriate salutes as if outdoors. You are also reminded that smoking is prohibited in the gymnasium. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the invocation given by the Battalion Chaplain General Miller.
Eternal God, we are forever grateful and thankful for your presence with us today. God, we thank you for being with our soldiers and for all the answered prayer that's gone up for the last 8 weeks or so. Father, continue to bless these soldiers wherever they go and their families. And God, we ask your blessings be upon the great nation, the United States of America. Amen.
Please be seated. Participating in today's ceremony from your left to your right are the 282nd Army Victory Band, graduating soldiers from Company A, the Color Guard consisting of drill sergeants from the 2nd Battalion, 13th Infantry Regiment, and graduating soldiers from Company B. Identified by their distinctive headgear are the drill sergeants. These dedicated men and women form the backbone of the Army's training center system. Selected on the basis of professional competence, leadership ability, and years of service, these men and women undergo intensive training to earn the right to wear their distinctive headgear and insignia. With the drill sergeant hat comes the important responsibility of both the young men and women into soldiers. The commander of troops for today's ceremony is Major Wayne Ashcroft, who serves as the battalion executive officer. He and his staff are now taking their position on the floor.
Bring your units to present arms.
Present arms.
Present arms.
Take a post. Bring your units to order arms.
Bring your units to present arms.
Center! March!
For the fellows on board, we will give honor to our nation for salute and the playing of the national anthem. It is appropriate for those not in uniform to place their right hand over their heart. Ladies.
Sir, the fellows of persons to honor present, present the command.
Thank you. Sergeant Major Ford, Officer Sergeant Ford, Sergeant Major Ford, ladies and gentlemen, Lieutenant General Kruger, Commander of the 2nd Battalion, 13th Infantry Regiment.
General, this is Alistair, Colonel Splinters, Colonel Keeters, Colonel Carver, Colonel Narwhal, other distinguished guests, and most importantly to our soldiers and their families and friends, welcome here today to this great ceremony. Soldier looks superb today, and you should on this great day. Drill Sergeants, once again, the fruits of your labor are seen before you. You did a great job of signing up for these civilians and the soldiers, despite all the help and advice I need. Your fruits of your labor will really be felt when you return to your operational units to serve alongside these same soldiers. To the family members of these fine soldiers, thank you for making this long journey here. I will tell you that it's only because of your efforts and your communications that helped these soldiers through these last 8 weeks. The soldiers you see in the floor before you have come a long way in the last 8 weeks. They are not the same soldiers to whom you said goodbye to. Collectively, these two companies have done approximately 1 million push-ups. They've lost about 2.5 tons of weight. They've eaten about 6,000 MREs. They walk differently, and they talk differently. And there'll be many a mother who's going to hear their son or daughter say hula to every question they ever ask. We've given them a pretty heavy dose of Army in the last 8 weeks. You're going to have to bear with us for a while. But now they begin to look and feel like soldiers. The soldiers you see on the floor before you have come to us from very many backgrounds. We have soldiers from every state in the Union and from four of the territories. We have soldiers from five different foreign countries. We have soldiers who worship in the country churches and great temples in the cities, representing virtually every religious conviction you can imagine. They're black, white, yellow, and every color in between. They're male and female. And what they found in the last 8 weeks is their differences didn't pull them apart, but rather made them stronger. They found their differences, turned them into a team, into a single unit with one mission in mind. In short, they learned to act like soldiers. The soldiers you see on the floor before you have changed greatly. They've been faced with a million new ideas and new concepts. Suddenly, someone else is taking advantage of you, someone else you're willing to give your time to and expense to yourself, is no longer being done in by someone, but rather maybe that's selfless service. These soldiers have tossed around the Army values, the seven Army values: courage, respect, honor, integrity, loyalty, duty, and selfless service. They've thought about these things, they've talked about these things, they've analyzed themselves, they analyze others. They're learning to grow into soldiers, learn to think like soldiers. They've got a long ways to go, but I think they've already seen and hear the differences in their speech. All you soldiers, you're different than 8 weeks ago. 8 weeks ago, you're a bunch of confused, scared puppies walking through the battalion area. Come a long way since that time. You stand a little taller, you slouch a little less, you look people in the eye a little straighter. You finally earn the right to be called soldiers. Soldiers are the most powerful and greatest army in the world, the greatest army that ever was. You've earned that with prime membership, and no one can take that away from you. You now are part of the legacy of the men and women who defended freedom around the world for over 200 years. Good luck as you go to your advanced individual training and on to your operational units. Good luck with everything you do. May God speak you. 40 rounds, first team, victory starts here.
And dedication to its continued existence. The uniform you wear at this moment is more than an outward display of your vocational choice. That uniform is a symbol of a nation and an unspoken assurance to all who see you that you are a dedicated, willing, and competent protector of the Constitution of the United States of America. You have become what you are set out to be, a soldier of the United States Army, and through this reconfirmation of your oath as a soldier, a protector of our nation's Constitution. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand as we come close to reaffirm the oath of allegiance to the Constitution of the United States of America. Those who are there present on the audience who wish to participate may do so. We ask that you also remain standing to the flame of the Army Song, Roger Jump, and the retiring of the colors.
Bring your units to attention!
Thank you.
this concludes the ceremony. Dismiss our soldiers.
Ladies and gentlemen,
take charge of your country.
We ask that you would please remain seated until the soldiers without visitors have departed the nation. This concludes today's ceremony. On behalf of the commanding general and graduating soldiers, thank you for being with us this morning.
Videorama is part of the Morale, Welfare, and Recreation Division of Fort Jackson. All revenue received from this project and other MWR activities go toward improving the quality of life for all the soldiers at Fort Jackson and toward providing a community of excellence.